Welcome to Menomonee Falls High School for a Greater Metro Conference boys basketball matchup. Brookfield Central visits Menomonee Falls here on Falls Cable Access. There's a look at the gym. The crowd still filtering in here. Yet 10-12 minutes before tip-off, and this is the first game for both teams in the Greater Metro race this year. The Falls Indians come in 0-2, and Brookfield Central 0-1 after a tough loss to Germantown. I'm John Merkier, and Bill Hintz is here as well. Bill, what do you think so far of the young season for these two ball clubs?
Well, you know, Brookfield Central got off to a great start. They're playing the number one team in the state. They were 28-0 last year,
yeah.
and they obviously were replacing some of their better players. But Brookfield Central, it came down to literally a last-second tip-in to be able to beat Brookfield Central, 66-64. So if that's any indication of what kind of a team Brookfield Central's got this year, they've got the height. They're 6'8".
They're very athletic.
They've got a first-team all-conference selection coming back in LaChance. And instead of scoring his traditional 15 points per game, he scored 32 points in the first game, just to make sure everybody noticed that he was really serious.
Against the top team
in the state.
In the state of Wisconsin.
Yeah, absolutely.
So they've only played one game. The Indians have played two games. It's still very early on in the season. What are folks saying about how the Greater Metro's supposed to shape up this year and how these two teams are likely to do?
Well, I think everybody kind of figured that the Lancers were going to be kind of the cream of the crop because they had a first-team all-conference player mm-hmm. coming back. They've got some height. They've got some, you know, ability. They play a really, really smart 1-3-1 zone, kind of a matchup type of thing. We'll talk a little bit about that. And so I think they really are considered kind of the cream of the crop right now. Hamilton also, I think, would also be considered, you know, the top 2-3 teams in that group there. And you can see from last year, West Dallas Central was 12-2 in the conference and 19-5 overall. So they had the best season by far that West Dallas Central had in a long, 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 long time. And then Central right behind them at 11-3, Tosi East 8-6, along with the Falls. And then Hamilton, although they were 6-8, they were playing a lot of youngsters. And so I think that's going to be the real telling tale there. They've got a Brady Ellingson that's going to be outstanding this year and come back. And of course, Marquette even slipped. Look at, they were at 6-8 and not particularly great year, but again, playing a lot of the younger players as well.
Riley LaChance, only a junior too, and he
right.
gets it done on a lot of ways. He can beat you off the dribble. He can drain that three-pointer. He's
right.
a dangerous player. And then when you look at Luke Rasmussen, who's a big kid inside, it makes it awfully tough to defend
right.
against the Lancers.
Well, and then they also have Elijah Goodman, who is a 6'4" player, and he was their second leading scorer in the game against Germantown. And if you're 6'4" and you're going against some of the taller kids on that
yeah.
Germantown team, and you got 15 points, I don't care if it was putbacks or free throws or whatever, hey, you're the real deal if you can score 15 on the inside against Germantown. So I think that was really great.
Let's talk in broad strokes about the Indians. Kind of a little bit of a rebuilding year. They lost some pieces last year. They do have Brandon Ramey back. Jason Prochet is back. I guess this Indians team still trying to find their identity a little bit, trying to figure it out as we head into the third game of the season.
And they're not at full strength. They've still got a couple of players out. They've got one player out with a sprained ankle. Another player, the 6'5", is not available tonight. So, I mean, you know, they're going to be a different team as the season progresses. And, of course, the challenge for Dan Leffelin is only his second year. He had 1 year coaching, obviously, J.P. Tokido,
yes.
which was an exciting experience, I'm sure, for any coach at any level. But then now he's gone, and what really Dan wants to do is establish himself as not only a good coach, but also as a program that is consistent year in and year out. And so Dan's the type of guy that's going to be able to work real hard on that. He's very organized. He's got the lower levels organized. He's got his freshman JV programs organized. And, you know, I think, you know, he's here for the long haul, and he's going to do a great job.
And they're a little bit under the radar this year. Not high expectations for this Menomonee Falls squad. Maybe he can use that to his advantage. And it must be such a change from when you go to having a team with one guy that everybody is focused on, that everybody knows, that fills up the gyms throughout the conference, to a younger team that has to play more like a complete team, find their identity, and figure out how to get it done night in, night out in a very tough basketball conference.
Well, and to that point, I think the challenge that Dan told me about was the fact that he was convinced that if he could just get his players to be more consistent from the shooting perspective, he did not feel they shot particularly well in the Sheboygan North Tournament. I'll tell you real honestly, I remember when I coached against Tom Desitil, who has been there 46 years at Sheboygan North. You play a game up in Sheboygan, and let's just say there's a tremendous home court advantage. and so, you know, I think it was great that Dan took the team up there and they played, you know, and everything else. And
but
I think
not
they
easy.
Had some, but it's not easy. And they played Plymouth, and Plymouth is a very tough Division II team. Mm-hmm. So, you know, he immediately challenged his team to play two tough year-in, year-out programs that are very competitive at their place. So I think down the road that could pay some dividends as long as everybody's head can stay on straight and he stays positive.
You're watching Greater Metro Basketball on Falls Cable Access, just a few moments away from tip-off. Let's do this. Why don't we run through the hints from hints? We've hit on a couple of these in broad strokes. Let's dive in a little deeper on what these two teams are going to need to do to win. Let's start with the Falls.
Absolutely. So tonight, the Falls has to contain LaChance and Goodman. Now, LaChance and Goodman were the big scorers, like I mentioned before, 32 points and 15 points in the first game against Germantown, the number one rated team in the state. And then they also have to limit turnovers, so they can't be foolish with the ball. They've got to make every possession count. And Coach Leffel also talked about the fact that they've got to rebound strong, box out. They got to play team D, and they cannot let Brookfield Central have second and third shots. If they can limit them to one shot per possession or less, then they're going to really, really have a good chance there. So I think that rebounding, boxing out, and that's fundamentals basketball. If you can play team defense and then rebound and box out, then a lot of the other things will take care of themselves.
Especially with a young team, you got to make sure you have those fundamentals.
And especially since he's a little nervous about, you know, the shooting confidence. Mm-hmm. And young guys, they will get into streaks, and then you just have to build on that, all right, let's keep it going and stuff. But they can start out kind of slow and kind of soft, and if they don't hit their first shot, it's an uphill battle every night. And then finally, they have to attack the 1-3-1 with passing and good shot selection. And again, if they could just hit a couple initially off of that, there's gaps in a 1-3-1, and that's what you're looking for to break that. Mm-hmm. You're going to hit the deep corners and the wings when they do double down and shift and everything else in that. You're probably not going to get a lot on the inside, but there is a possibility of getting some offensive rebounds.
Brookfield Central is probably the favorite coming into this ball game, even though they've only played one game because of who they have back, because of how they did against Germantown in the opener. What are the hints for Brookfield Central to win this ball game?
Well, I think that especially when you're looking at Brandon Ramey and a few of the other players on the Falls, they really do have to hit their threes. And so if I'm Mark Adams, and Mark Adams is a great coach, we're going to talk about him in a mm-hmm. second, but, you know, he really has to contest every one of those three-point shots. He does not want Ramey or anybody else, for that matter, to get any confidence from that three-point
line. No open looks.
So even though it's a 1-3-1 zone, what they really want is contesting every single shot. And they have to get the ball in the hands of LaChance and Goodman, who are obviously their two leading scorers. I mentioned go for the win number 199.
Yes.
This is fascinating. Mark Adams has been around for a while. He's actually only been a head coach for 13 years, but been in coaching for years. Matter of fact, he was coaching when I was coaching. And tonight would be his 199th victory.
Wow.
If he gets it tonight. And, of course, Falls will do everything he can to stop that. And if they would have beaten Germantown, tonight would have been going for his 200, which is even a greater pressure, you know. And then the last thing, again, build on the Germantown effort. It was a great start. I talked to Mark before the game, and he mentioned how, you know, he just felt so good about the effort and so good about what they were able to do against, like I said, at least the preseason number one ranked team in the state.
You know, I had a chance before the game to talk to Coach Leffel, mm-hmm. and they come in 0-2. He knows he has a young team. He knows he doesn't have all his weapons yet available to him, and he said he feels pretty good. The team's been practicing well. He says the effort is there. Sometimes the confidence isn't always there, and the minute decision-making isn't always there. But he says the fundamentals are, and he thinks this team will get rolling, and it's kind of a tough opener. This is a tough conference opener. Central is the real deal. Big expectations for that squad, which makes it a tough matchup for the Indians to start the year.
Yeah, I mean, you know, in the perfect world, if you could, you know, take on a team from last year that maybe didn't play particularly well, didn't win a lot of games, mm-hmm. you know, a Hale or even a Brookfield East or something like that, it might be a nice warm-up for it. But, you know, Leffel's got his hands full. Like I said, that Sheboygan North tournament was no slouch, and then being here against the number one team in at least the preseason for the Greater Metro Conference, that he's definitely got his hands full.
Last year, the two clubs split. They played in about this time last year, and Brookfield Central won that game by 6, and then they played again in January near the end of the season, and Falls came out. They won big that game. That kind of set the tone for when they began to turn things around a little bit. We're about 2 minutes away from the lineups being announced. I want to ask you quickly, Coach, so if you're the Falls and you play this 1-3-1, not a lot of teams play 1-3-1. They don't see this look a lot. What are the keys to beating and breaking down that 1-3-1 zone that Brook Central
will
play?
Well, number one, it is passing. It's exactly what they mentioned in the pregame. They definitely have to pass well. And what that means is you don't telegraph your passes. You don't hold the ball over your head a lot. What you really want to do is be quick, be sharp with the ball, great passes. And then great passing actually opens up opportunities for shots. Now, occasionally, if you can hit a couple of outside shots, then the guys have to step further out and cover the shooter, and then they can't pack it in as tight on the inside and can't box out as well. So the key is passing. The second key is hitting a couple of those outside shots. And if those two things happen, then, you know, maybe Central's going to have their hands full.
Falls not with a lot of height. They come in with a distinct height disadvantage. I guess that makes boxing out the fundamentals even more important.
Yeah, we used to always talk about this. I think, John, you and I have worked before, and I always talked about, you know, true rebounding is position and desire.
Yep.
It really doesn't have anything to do with how tall you are. Because if I'm 5'10", which is what I am, if I am 5'10", and I'm guarding a guy that's 6'4", the only way, if I box out correctly and I desire it more than he does, the only way he can get it is if he goes over my back.
Commit a foul.
And commit a foul to get it. You know, so box out well, do it fundamentally sound, make sure you got a body on somebody, and you can rebound with bigger guys.
There you see the Indians going through their last-minute warm-ups. The Lancers are set to come over to their bench areas. We tick down here and get ready for this Greater Metro opener. Let's set the stage for you once again. We are at Menomonee Falls High School. This is the first game here at the high school this year. The crowd is pretty much settled in for this Greater Metro opener, the beginning of about a two-month-plus season. Both teams having already played, the Indians 0-2. The Lancers come into this game 0-1. And we're just about set for basketball here. We'll see if the Indians come out and get the tempo that they like or if the Lancers establish tempo. There we have tick down. Let's listen to PA announcer Jerry Missling.
Men and women in the armed forces, especially those serving overseas and away from their friends and families, especially during the holiday season, please rise, remove your hats, and be respectful for the playing of our national anthem. Tonight's national anthem will be sung by senior Gianna Tarantino.
Thank you.
Beautiful job by senior Gianna Tarantino with tonight's national anthem. I always like to watch the players as they're getting ready, and I was looking at Riley LeChance, and there is just a calm confidence as he stands there getting ready for tonight's ball game.
Absolutely. And one last thought on Gianna Tarantino. You and I have watched enough of those kind of, national anthems. That is a tough song to sing.
It is.
She did a great job of personalizing it and really sounding strong and positive, and congratulations to her for a great job.
Let's listen to Jerry introduce the Brookfield Central Lancers.
For the Lancers, a 6 foot junior, number 10, Brad Noonan. A 6'3 senior, number 15, Peter Mariachi. A 6'2 junior, number 25, Riley LeChance. A 6'4 junior, number 35, Elijah Goodman. And a 6'8 junior, number 44, Luke Rasmussen. Let's have a nice hand for the Brookfield Central Lancers.
That is the Brookfield Central High School Lancers. Not a senior in the starting lineup. Now let's meet the Indians.
Led by second-year head coach Dan Buffalo, assistant coach Lewis Giles. Menomonee Falls comes in with a record of 0-3. Now the starting lineup for the Indians. 6'4 and one half junior, number 2, Daniel Dolke. 6 foot junior, number 4, Jordan Richardson. 5'8 senior, number 11, Brandon Ramey. 6'3 junior, number 22, Jason Pershay. And a 6'2 senior, number 33, Zach Murray. Let's have a nice hand for your Menomonee Falls.
Zach Murray, the beef in the middle of that lane for the Indians as we get set for the tip-off here. This is going to be a battle for the Indians. They need to make sure they stick in this thing, hang in there. A lot of underclassmen on both teams starting. Of course, the big exception for the Indians is Brandon Ramey, who comes in averaging 12 points a game. He's knocked down five three-pointers in the first couple of games. Does most of his damage from the outside. Ramey has only gotten to the free throw line once so far this year.
You know, and as I look at more closely now, this it looks like Peter Mariachi is actually a senior. So there's one senior on each team right now. So kind of interesting. Everybody else is underclassmen. You can't miss Mr. Ramey with those electric shoes that he's wearing.
And we'll spend a lot of time looking after Riley LeChance as well this evening. Set to tip it off here from Menomonee Falls High School. Let's get this bad boy started. We're underway, and the tip goes to the Indians, and Ramey is on the ball.
There's that 1-3-1. Very aggressive on the top.
Gets it over to Richardson. Back to Ramey, looking inside. Swings it back to Richardson.
See, and they're fighting it. They don't want it to get to the other side of the court. They don't want him to rotate that ball. It's harder for a zone to cover when it goes from side to side.
Richardson looks inside. Two-man game so far. Ramey looking to penetrate. Backs it back out of that zone. Inside and back out to Ramey. Richardson ends up with it. Passes on the shot. There's the long pass to Murray. Murray kicks it back out to Richardson. Richardson over to Ramey. That's Richardson. Crochet on the wing, working hard, unable to get open. Ramey back to Richardson. 1 minute gone by. The Indians have been on the ball, possessing the ball, have yet to take a shot. There's a kick ball. We'll reset, and the Indians will inbound.
And what the Indians are showing is great patience. You know, they don't mind that, you know, Central is not having the opportunity to score a lot of points yet. And they're testing it out. They want to see if I penetrate here, if I go there, do they double team, what exactly is open.
Good clean passes so far by the Indians. That's to Murray. Murray looks to swing it and does. Here's Pershay with the look. Jumper on the way, and it's good.
Excellent.
Count it. That's three. Jason Pershay from the corner.
That's a pretty impressive patience. And then finally they swung it deep, got it to the opposite corner, and great shot by Pershay.
They look inside to Goodman. Goodman gets the ball. Goodman looks to go glass, swings it. That's Riley LeChance. Riley LeChance on the dribble. Jumper on the way. Can't get it to fall. Oh, what nice work inside. Luke Rasmussen tips it over to Goodman.
Yeah, if the two big men can play together like that, this could be a long night.
That was a beautiful pass. Ramey to Richardson. Richardson looks inside, puts it on the floor. Back over to Ramey. 3-2 Indians on top, second possession, 6:03 left in the first quarter. Ramey looks inside. Richardson with the look, passes on it. Murray. Nice pass to Prochet. Prochet cuts to the basket, can't get it to go. Wow, nice pass, nice look, and the Lancers come out with the ball. Rasmussen hard to the rack.
Excellent. Wow.
Offensive foul.
That is tough. I'd say Zach Murray did a great job of positioning himself so that he could take that offensive charge.
That's a big boy, 6'8", Luke
Rasmussen. We used to make a big deal about somebody who sacrificed their body, took the charge, guy coming in hard, knocking you over and everything else. So Murray did a great job defensively. It's nice work.
First foul on Rasmussen, first team foul. Indians back on the ball. It's Ramey.
Yeah.
And the block is called. Ramey dribbles into traffic. Lancers whistled for the foul. That foul is going to be on Mattiacci.
Yeah, you got to be careful in the penetration. If you go too deep, you can get triple teamed, and then it's really hard to get the ball out.
Back into the backcourt. Ramey sets the offense. Lancers extend the pressure. Richardson back into the front court. A lot of tossing over the top of that one in the zone. Richardson back on the ball. Looks into Murray. Ramey swings it, quick pass to Prochet, back to Ramey. The Indians doing a nice job moving the basketball. Prochet inside, tough shot, can't get it to fall. Knocked out of bounds, that's going to stay here with the Indians. Good hustle, Jason Prochet.
It looks like what it is there's a weakness on the return because, see the baseline guy there, number 10, Brad Newman, he's got to run baseline. He's got to get over there, so the Falls has determined that, and now that's what they're going to do. They're going to try to swing it deep to the opposite corner.
Now they bring Prochet up between the rings. It's Richardson. Richardson looks for Ramey and gets him the ball. 4:48 left here in the first quarter. Indians very patient. Ramey on the court. Zach Murray. Look inside, and the finish. Daniel Dahlke.
Nice job. Nice passes. There it is, right there. I don't know if I like the bounce pass in the lane, but
got the job done that time.
That's right. It worked, I guess. I can't complain if it works, I guess.
First quarter is only halfway over, and Brookfield Central is the ball for only the second time.
Right. And here we've got a 3-point lead. Who would have thought halfway into the quarter you'd be in that situation?
Well, Chance has had one shot so far. He did not knock it down. 0-for-1. Coming off that 32-point effort against Germantown. Here come the Indians. They get it across the midcourt stripe. Indians being very patient with this 1-3-1 zone. Nice pass to Murray. Murray, that's not really his shot. Doesn't knock it down. Here come the Lancers, and they look to push the ball.
Yeah, the patience is working. It's sometimes hard to maintain it for a long period of time.
Look inside for Rasmussen. Good hustle. Knocked out of bounds by Richardson. Good defense. The Lancers will inbound down 5-2. LaChance misses the bunny, and here come the Indians. Ramey pushes the ball. Pulls it back out to Richardson, and we settle back in again. 5-2 Indians. Murray on the dribble looking for help. Gets it to Ramey. Jumper on the way. Downtown. Knocks it down. Brandon Ramey from beyond the arc.
Nice job. I tell you, the Falls is well prepared to attack this 1-3-1.
Murray with a very nice look there, and Ramey finishes. Lancers look inside for Goodman. Goodman trying to post up. Instead, it's LaChance. Oh, almost picked off. Prochet, pressure on the ball. That's Goodman. That's two big boys battling right there, Goodman and Murray. It's a lot of beef. Here's LaChance from downtown. LaChance off the mark early. Nice rebound, Goodman. Can he finish? He cannot. Battle for the ball. Goodman again. Wow. Three looks. Goodman whistled. He'll go to the line.
Well, and give it to the Falls. They're battling in there. They're trying to get some rebounds. It's just that the big guys with the beef have a little bit of an advantage from a physical standpoint. But the other nice thing is I see the officials kind of like letting it play a little bit. And I don't know, that might, maybe that would play well for the Falls tonight. Usually I like things called a little bit tighter than that, but right now it looks like they're letting it go.
Devin Jackson and Anthony Russo check in for the Indians. Richardson and Preche will come out of the ball game. Preche didn't want to leave the floor. He's like, me? Come on, me? Goodman missed the first one. Second one will be on the way. Goodman misses both free throws. Here come the Indians, up 8-2 early. 2:40 left. First period here from Menomonee Falls High School, 8-2 Indians. Ramey over to Russo. They extend the pressure a little bit now, do the Lancers. Russo tests, puts it on the floor, looking for help. Murray's got Murray in the corner, kicks it back to Ramey instead. Jumper on the way. Devin Jackson can't get it to fall, and here comes LaChance and the Lancers. Rasmussen up high. LaChance turns baseline, floater on the way. Riley LaChance gets on the board.
Yeah, driving baseline, nice little soft, little almost jump hook to put that one in.
Indians lose the ball. LaChance can't save it. Devin Jackson resets for the Indians. Over to Russo, 1:40 left. There's Russo, open look downtown. Russo, count it. Anthony Russo.
This is exactly what they needed. Patience on the passing, a couple of fake the passes, and then hit the open man.
They've knocked three down from downtown.
Makes a huge difference. You know, I find it interesting, too. Did you notice where they're playing Luke Rasmussen? He's
up
on
top.
The wing of the 1-3-1. Mm-hmm. He's on the wing of the 1-3-1.
Now, we've got some confusion here.
He's not the center of that action on the defense. They got 35 in there. Goodman is the one who's holding down the inside court there.
And the sophomore, Paul Coyer, checks into the ball game. Dahlke will get a rest.
Paul Coyer, nice young man, sophomore, brought up from the JV team to help out, give a spell to some of the big guys.
6'5 sophomore into the ball game. Indians up 11-4 and set to inbound. 1:22 left in the opening quarter.
Fouls on number 44, Luke Rasmus.
Ramey to Russo.
Team third.
Ramey with those bright lime green shoes. Russo inside. Nice look. Coyer loses the handle.
Yeah.
Coyer loses that ball out of bounds.
Coyer kind of got himself turned around there and picked up and then kind of lost track of where he was. And
hit the bottom of the backboard.
He was in too tight. Yeah. Yeah. In too tight. Tough one.
Here come the Lancers trying to cut into this 7-point Indian lead. It's LaChance.
Back pick.
Goodman up top, guarded by Murray. Here's LaChance. LaChance looks to pick. LaChance turns the ball over. That's Coyer who comes out of there with it. Hands it off to Devin Jackson inside. That's a turnover, Indians.
Nice deflection. Now watch this. Pressure on LaChance. Get the hands up. See right there. 23. Anthony Russo got a tip on that. Deflected it. Created a turnover. You also, we haven't even talked about this, but notice, you know, Falls is not afraid. They're playing straight up man-to-man.
LaChance lets it fly, nothing but net. A little bit of confusion on the defense there. LaChance steps back and knocks it down.
Of all the things that there cannot be confusion on is who's got LaChance.
Know where Riley LaChance is. Coyer with the little jumper off the mark. Rebound, that's gathered in by the Lancers. I don't really know if that's Coyer's shot. LaChance takes it to the rim. Can't get it to fall. Gets his own rebound and knocks it in.
Yeah, see, there you can't box it. You got to box out. Can't let him have a second shot. Somebody like that. See here, turn around, box out. Nobody boxed him out. He puts it back in.
10 seconds left. Will the Indians get a good look? That's Preche. Murray. Murray lets it fly. Can't get it to go. Brook Central gathers, and that's going to end the first quarter. At the end of one, 11-9 Indians on top. I would have to think, Coach, that you're happy with the score at the end of one, But a couple things that you probably aren't too happy with, especially the way it ended.
Yeah, you kind of let them get on a roll. And you mentioned it. I forgot to compliment you. You were talking about Temple and who was going to control Temple. And even though the Lancers are the bigger team, I think they want to run a little bit.
I think they do. I think LeChance wants to run.
What they got was the chance to run in the last 4 minutes that they didn't get in the first 4 minutes. You know, because they were controlling the tempo so much that there wasn't a lot of action. So it's almost like the Falls tonight wants to kind of slow the action down and be more deliberate. And, you know, Central is kind of like, hey, we want to get out. We got, you know, we're scoring 60 points a game. We want to get up there and, you know. And remember, you know, in the back, we've always talked about what do you have as a goal, a defensive goal per quarter and stuff. And I always said that if you could hold a varsity team to less than 12 points in a quarter, you got a good chance of winning, but you got to do that more than one quarter. If you can keep them down 12 or less in every quarter, you can beat them.
Brook Central scored 64 their first game. The Indians come in averaging 54 points a game.
Right.
I think that's a very good point you make. The Falls very deliberate, very patient, limiting the possessions and therefore the looks by the Lancers. The Lancers, with Brad Newman and Riley LeChance, really looking to push the ball and score points in bunches. The Indians limit the damage. 11-9 Indians on top. Brook Central set to inbound to begin this second quarter. Look inside to Goodman, big man with position. Good defense by the Indians, and he traveled. Little baby steps, turnover.
That was very fortunate. Yeah, he did. He just did move the pivot foot. Good call.
Indians with hands in the air. The turnover is called. Mark Adams doesn't like it right in front of us, but the Indians have the basketball.
Step through it. Oh. Got to get two hands on there.
A little bit of pressure bothering the Indians.
The thing that's going to be really important for the Falls defense is they've got to pressure the passer. They can't let the ball get inside so easily. Now, notice their big guy is out, and really it's now Goodman that's the center of the attention.
Ah, that's a ticky-tack foul. Coyer reached in there, LeChance.
And that's the big change from a JV player to a varsity player is how much faster things go in a varsity game.
Well, especially Riley LeChance. They're going
to And Paul Coyer, he'll get used to it by the end of the game, but right away he didn't realize how fast those offensive players can be on varsity level.
Boy, Goodman is a big boy. Central breaks it down. Oh, and they call the block. Prochet gets called for the block. Here, we'll take another look at that.
See, his feet weren't set.
Not
That's
set.
A good call. I know we'd love to say, oh, yeah, that was good. But, see, he actually stepped on his foot there and still in the movement process. So,
not a shooting foul. Brook Central will inbound the ball.
Great replay.
Wow, that is too easy. Off the inbound pass, Caleb Mortag.
Yeah, see, and if you're going to play man-to-man on the inbounds play, you can't let a guy just simply, you know, kind of walk to the lane and put the ball up for a layup.
We are tied at 11. Indians on the ball. Coyer looks back out to Richardson. Swing to Ramey. There's a wide-open look for Shea. For Shea on the way, off the mark. Great board. Dahlke can't finish. And here come the Lancers. A couple of good looks by the Indians. A chance between the rings.
Dahlke got up there, didn't he?
He did. That was a nice rebound. Inside look.
Inside. Nice steal.
One too many passes. Here comes Prochet. Prochet looking to go coast to coast. Can't finish it.
You got to stop the ball.
And the Indians are going to get called for a foul.
Yeah, see, now that was the bounce pass in the lane. Everybody saw that. And I know I harp on that all the time, but I'll tell you, I have seen more balls get deflected and stolen when there's a bounce pass in the lane, in the paint, as we used to say. You know, you don't need that. If you're that close to somebody, you don't need the bounce pass. You need to get it up high.
Inside look. That's the second time in a row.
See, they're just
off the inbound. They've finished.
See, it's a back pick, and that's why the guy's getting open, but you got to have somebody over there to help out.
Too easy for Goodman. That's knocked out of bounds. The Indians will keep the basketball. 6:08 left. Indians now down by two. I think we were at, was it 11-4?
11-9. Well, oh, you mean in terms of, biggest spread?
Yeah.
8-2, 6, yeah. So.
Nice look for Murray inside. Back to Dahlke. Dahlke looks to finish, and he does. Nice look. Nice pass by Murray.
assist from Murray.
Right, so
there's Murray with the
up.
Interior pass. Dahlke gathers, and he finishes off the window.
Nice.
30-second timeout.
Yeah, hey, you know, I wanted to just say before, those two inbounds plays that resulted in easy layups for Brookfield Central, that's kind of what I, one of the arts that I think has been kind of lost in some of the current basketball. Everybody's so interested in the three-point shot and the fast break and everything else.
Slam dunk.
They've forgotten the finesse and the beauty of a well-designed inbounds play. Mark Adams is a great example of coming from that generation where they were meticulous about making sure that there were options on the inbounds plays. And then, you know, if you can score every time you get, let's say, an inbounds play underneath the basket, that's a plus. That's
well, on the other side of that, it must drive Coach Leffel crazy. You're playing man-to-man. You got to keep the guy on your outside shoulder. Two easy baskets
right
at the face of the rim. We're tied at 13. LaChance to Goodman. Back to LaChance, looking to make it happen. Looks inside. Good defense. Kick, jumper on the way. That's knocked down. Terry Wallen.
Yeah, junior guard. Nice ball rotation. Found the guy that was open.
Indians look to settle the ball back down. It's Richardson now in the backcourt with Jawan McLeod for the Indians. That is McLeod on the ball. Richardson looks to create some space. That's McLeod. Prechet down in the corner. They say Prechet shuffled his feet. Turnover Indians. Indians a little bit sloppy. They're down by three here.
Yeah, their crisp passing that they had at the very beginning, they've kind of lost a little bit. Of course, now they're subbing. So you got different people in there, but they've got to be sharp passes, and they cannot be slow passes like bounce passes. They got to be quick. Yeah, I was going to say, they can't keep Ramey out too much. He's coming back in.
LaChance tried to draw the foul, thought he was fouled. Uh-uh, here come the Indians. Forced that shot up after he believed he felt contact. Look inside, nice cut. Oh, you got to finish that. That was a beautiful pass, a beautiful cut.
Jordan Richardson, great, great pass down underneath. Just missed the layup.
Jumper on the way, wide open look. That is off the mark. Here comes Prechet. Prechet with a man on his left, gives it up. Jump shot on the way. That is off the mark as well. LaChance with the rebound. LaChance looks up court. His team up by three, gives it up. Nice pass inside. Get that out of here.
Wow.
Murray goes down. Goodman puts the shot up. Let's take another look at this.
I tell you, Dolphins got some ups. Look at that.
Goodman just missed that. Came off the rim, and then it was smacked out of bounds.
Yeah, trying to draw the charge. Official not impressed, and I will tell you why. I've got the secret to why
that's
it was
three.
Not called.
That's three. That's the third time that's happened.
Off an inbounds play.
Wow, that is way too easy.
Yeah, we could diagram those babies.
Coach Leffel right in front of us is not a happy camper. Indians down by five. Close in on 4 minutes left in this ball game. Richardson swings it. That is thrown away out of bounds. Ramey would have to be 8 feet tall to have had a shot at that.
Yeah.
Take care of the basketball. That's a lot of turnovers in this second quarter for the Indians.
And we talked about the fact that, you know, Falls could not afford a lot of turnovers. They can't have bad passes. They can't give it away easy.
Goodman with the inside position, and he knocks it down.
Yep.
Goodman with 8 points in this ball game. All of them on the inside.
Well, you know, and Goodman's just a workhorse on the inside. He's a blue-collar player inside.
I think they're going to get LaChance for the foul on that. LaChance trying to guard Ramey.
Ball's on number 25.
His first foul. Chance with one foul, 7 points. They've really limited the damage from LaChance. They're having trouble on the inside, though. The Indians giving up a lot of inside points.
Adele Shields into the game, senior.
They get it down to Shields. Shields in the corner, swing pass. That's Ramey. Ramey. Wow, that's from way downtown on the way off the mark. Here come the Lancers, up by seven. LaChance on the ball, guarded by Shields. Newman, doesn't get it to fall, but Newman is fouled on the play. That's going to be a shooting foul. Newman will go to the line.
Yeah, you know, contesting shot versus reaching in and actually touching the person while they're driving is not a good idea. See, you got to move the feet.
Newman attempting his first free throws of the year. That one is off the mark.
You know, in Brookfield Central, especially under the direction of Coach Adams, has always been a good free throw shooting team, especially late in the ball game. You do not want to be fouling the typical Lancer team.
Prochet checks back into the ball game. Murray will get a little bit of rest. 3:09 left here in the first half. Newman gets one out of two. The Indians in desperate need of a little bit of offense. McLeod over to Ramey, back to McLeod. McLeod swings it down to Shields. Prochet on the baseline as well. Indians struggling a little bit to figure out this zone. That's going to be a travel. Yeah, Shields kind of with the hop step.
It's a good call. Yeah, Shields stepped through and then got an extra step there. You know, the other thing that I'm seeing that's missing from the passing that they're doing, pass fakes before you start any dribbling or anything like that can also make the defense overwork. So it's not a bad idea to pass fake or shot fake to make that defense adjust a little bit and maybe find somebody open.
Jake Shore into the ballgame for the Indians. The Lancers on the ball, up by eight. Turnover, Shields. Here he comes, takes it to the rack.
Ugh.
That hurts. Dahlke with the rebound. Dahlke can't finish. The Indians miss two close-in attempts, and here come the Lancers. LaChance on the wing, guarded by the new guy into the game. Shore. Goodman, turnaround, wasn't pretty, but he hits glass and knocks it down. Goodman with 10 points here in the first half.
Yeah, he's the leading scorer right now.
Just took it at Dahlke, turned around and threw it off the glass, got it to go. That extends the lead to 10 points. The Indians with 2 points in this second quarter. Shields down, Shore, jumper on the way. That's not going to fall. Here come the Lancers. It's LaChance on the ball. Look inside. Nobody got back, and Newman made them pay for it. They had two guys that had beaten the Indian pressure.
Yeah, and to your point, they've scored 16 points to Falls only scoring two. So clearly that's not working well. But here's the thing. When you're in transition, and remember we talked about this, when you pointed out the tempo was going to be pretty big here, Brookfield Central wants to get up and down the floor because right now it doesn't look like Falls is getting back on D very well. And whenever you are playing defense in the transition game, the first order of business is to stop the ball. We got nobody stopping the ball, so that the person that's got the ball and is pushing it up the floor and is leading the charge, he can sit there and pick you apart and sees that there's two guys ahead of him that he can dump the ball off of and, you know, get an easy score. So.
You know, the Indians were actually up in the first half 11-4.
Mm-hmm.
So this is actually a 22-2 run.
Wow.
That the Lancers are on. 22-2 run. The Indians with 2 points this quarter. Boy, pretty tough to survive when you give up those kind of runs.
Right.
Dan Leffel, you see there, called the timeout, trying to talk over defense and offense with his team. Very young squad, trying to make sure they don't get knocked out of this thing before the first half is over.
Yeah. So in 1:41, you know, we're looking at a lead now of 12 points. And what you would try to do is establish as a coach maybe a goal of, all right, let's see if we can cut this to six. You know, between in the next 1:41. Now, how do you get to 6 points? You know, cutting it, you got to score and you got to prevent them from scoring. So don't let them score any points, and let's see if we can get maybe 6 points either from the free throw line or whatever.
Russo's back into the ballgame for the Indians. Another turnover. Russo can't find Ramey.
Indian substitution. Number four, Jordan Richardson.
Richardson back into the ballgame. Jake Shore, sits down.
Yeah, let's see, and we...
12-point Indian lead. Let's reset it for you. We got Richardson, Prochet, Dahlke, Ramey on the floor for the Indians, and Russo. There's LaChance on the ball. LaChance to Newman.
Looks to me like they're going to a lighter, faster lineup there.
Boy, Goodman inside again. He's got a dozen. The inside game is killing the Indians.
You know, and they're so close with this, trying to take a charge. That's not a good pass.
Newman with the turnover. Newman with the travel. Newman turns it right back over. Coach Leffel's not happy. He has a word with the official over here asking about something. The Indians set the inbound down by 14 points.
You know, in taking a charge, I was going to mention before, the reason that they're not getting the call, the falls not getting the call, is that when they get run over, they're not making any noise. They're just absorbing it. And they have to say, this guy ran me over by, you know, oof. I mean, you got to hear it.
There's the ball fake. Instead gives it to Ramey. Ramey back to Richardson. Ramey looking for some offense. He's got one basket so far tonight. 25 seconds left. Richardson on the ball. Falls looking for a good shot, wanting to end on an up note. It's Ramey. Ramey launches from way downtown. That's off the mark. Goodman with the rebound, and now the Lancers, it looks like, will likely get the last shot.
It's about a 22-foot shot, it looks like.
Yeah, that was way downtown. Jumper on the way, off the mark, and guess what? No box out on Goodman. He makes him pay, and he puts it down.
That's the end of the first half.
I can't wait to go over the hints from him.
Yeah. It is the end of the first half. The Lancers on top 29-13. Not a good second quarter for the Indians. They score 2 points. Riley LeChance for the Lancers has 7. Elijah Goodman has 14 points, all of them inside.
And a tale of two different quarters. You know, a quarter where really the Falls played pretty good and only lost it a little bit at the end. And then the second quarter, which was all, you know, Brookfield Central. And give credit to Central. The players, as well as Coach Adams, you know, made some adjustments at the end of the first quarter, did some nice things, and, you know,
look at the result. A 25-2 run, yeah. Coach. A 25-2 run. It was 11-4 Indians.
Right.
That's pretty tough. All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be back with we're not going to take a break, are we? All right, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back. You are watching Falls Cable Access Metro Basketball.
All right, the halftime contest tonight is sponsored by Jimmy John's Gourmet Subs on Pilgrim and Silver Spring. Jimmy John's features a wide variety of sub sandwiches and freaky fast delivery. Tonight's contest will feature four groups, starting with the freshmen, then sophomores, then juniors, and of course ending with the seniors. The name of the game is to make as many free throws as possible in 24 seconds. If there is a tie, we will be broken by a rock, paper, scissors. The first group is Devin Gottiger and Johan Figueroa. These are freshmen, Devin Gottiger, Johan Figueroa. I have no clue. The winner is Devin Gottiger. You can come and take one of your free subs, some Jimmy John's. Get over here freaky fast. Tonight's sophomores are John Enright and Quinn Hinton. All right, once again, I believe we had John Enright defeating Quentin Handy by a wide margin. The next ones will be juniors. This ought to be a good contest between
We are at halftime at Menomonee Falls High School. This Greater Metro matchup has the Brookfield Central Lancers on top of the Menomonee Falls Indians, 29-13. I think you said it best, Coach, a tale of two quarters. The Indians end the first quarter on top. The Lancers dominate the second quarter. Let's take a look at the hints from Hintz, because I think he had it right on the money. This is kind of the tale of what went down and what happened.
Yes.
Menomonee Falls, this is what they needed to do, evaluate how they've done.
Well, they definitely didn't contain Goodman. LaChance, they started out fairly good against them, but now, that's their two leading scorers right now, and they really have not done a very good job after the first quarter was over with. They, had a limited amount there. Limit the turnovers. They had this rash of turnovers. The rebounding, that they totally forgot about boxing out. I mean, that's a lot of the points have been off of at second and third shots. And remember, I said when we talked to Coach Leffel, he was talking about how important it was to limit them to maybe one or less shots per possession. And they're getting two or three and critical ones right off of the rebounds.
Did they effectively attack that zone?
Yeah, well, I mean, they did in the first, six minutes, and then all of a sudden they subbed. And then when they subbed, the rhythm, and I think they were learning some interesting things, but they haven't been able to adjust and do that well. And
let's look at what Brookfield Central needed to do if they wanted things to go their direction. I think we're going to see a little bit of a different story here.
Right. They've contested the three-point shots, and I think, what have we got, only one three-point shot?
No, we have three.
But
we haven't got a lot of good looks.
They have not had good looks. And, of course, they have gotten the ball to Goodman and LaChance. And Goodman's just, he's, like I said, I call him a blue-collar player. He goes out there and he's working. He's trying to get position. He's always fighting to get something that's going to work good. It's looking good for that 199 unless the Falls can come up with something here. And I think, although they were a little bit rusty in that first quarter, I think they realized what they did to play such a good game against Germantown, and I think we saw that in the second quarter. To me, second quarter was how they probably played against Germantown.
Let's go through some of the stats here as we get ready to begin the second quarter in about a minute and a half. The leading scorer for the Lancers is Elijah Goodman. He has 14 points. Riley LaChance has 7. Brad Newman has 1 basket and 3 points. Caleb Mortag had 2, and Wallen had 2 as well. Doesn't take very long to talk about the Indians scoring. They had 3 points from Brandon Ramey, a 3-pointer. Jason Prochet with 3, knocked down a long shot. Anthony Russo hit from downtown. He has 3 points. And Daniel Dahlke hit a couple mid-range shots. He has 4 points in this ballgame. The Indians came in averaging 54 points a game. They're going to really need to pick it up to hit that. Brookfield Central, 64 points a game.
There's the highlights of
here they are. That's Prochet from the wing, knocks down the one from downtown. That is the one jumper he knocked down. This is one of Dahlke's baskets on
inside,
the nice pass from Murray.
This is probably the weak side there. Yeah, okay, and then that's
Ramey knocking down the 3. And that's about it for the Falls Indians. So they had 11 points at the end of the first quarter. They have 13 at the end of halftime.
Yeah, that was quite a drought, as we would like to say.
That was quite a drought, a 25-2 run.
Yeah.
It looked like they were in it. Even at the beginning of the first quarter, you could begin to feel that Brookfield Central was getting things a little more their way.
Right. And to that point, the Falls, with a few of the seniors, they really got to take charge and say, that's enough of this. We got to score here. We got to, 2 points in an entire quarter. We talked before about how you set 12 or less. 2 points in a quarter is definitely not going to bode well for you.
The Indians will begin as they began the ball game with Murray, Richardson, Ramey, Prochet, and Dahlke. And the Lancers will also begin how they began the game with Newman, Mattiacci, Goodman, LaChance, and Luke Rasmus in the 6'8 junior back into the ball game. And the Indians begin with the ball down by 16, looking to chip away. Ramey on the dribble, gives it up to Murray. Murray swings it. That's Richardson. Rasmussen with those long legs knocks the ball out of bounds. The Indians will reset. Looking for Murray down in the corner, knocked out by Rasmussen. Back into the backcourt, here comes Richardson. That's tipped, gathered by Richardson. Aggressive defense by the Lancers. To turnover. Richardson turns the ball over, and Ramey steals it back. Here comes Ramey. He's got numbers, three on one. Ramey gives it up to Prochet, blocked by Newman, and now it's Brookfield Central at the rack, and he is fouled by Dahlke. Dahlke with the hard foul.
You know, and when we this is so frustrating because you obviously, you know, get a chance for an easy basket. Ramey held the ball too long, gave it up too late, and then bounced past it. And the bounce pass,
yeah.
Again, I understand there's some people that love the bounce pass, but it is the slowest pass in basketball.
And that made the difference.
And it made the difference because that let the defense catch up, and that's why he got snuffed.
Mariachi misses the first one. That's his first free throw attempt of the year.
And we should mention, too, you know, Mariachi at 6'3", that's why he's on the top of the 1-3-1. He's got kind of long arms, and he's fighting ball reversal. He wants to keep the ball on one side, so you split the court in half. Adams understands that and wants to keep it on one side so they can't get ball reversal.
That zone has given the Indians fits. Ramey thought about it. Murray looks inside. Instead, it's back to Ramey. Ramey Richardson swings it one more time. Prochet with the open look. Can't get it to fall. Prochet does get the rebound. Oh, that's a tough shot. Can't get it to fall. Murray battles inside. Who comes out of there with it? They're going to say that Dahlke, with nice hustle,
was out of bounds
as he touched the basketball.
Yeah. Good hustle.
Prochet with a really good look. Just couldn't get it
down. Look for stuff. Yep. Prochet with the square up. Good shot by our camera crew.
Here come the Lancers. They are up 30-13. LaChance on the basketball. LaChance with a tough shot, but he makes it look easy.
Well, I'll tell you, that's great. Great body control. Leaning there, trying to draw the foul. Probably could have been a foul call, but put it in. Didn't seem to affect his shot, so the officials didn't call that.
Murray on the floor. Ramey, wide open look. Ramey lets it fly, knocks it down from downtown. That's three.
Yeah, see that penetration on the baseline. Watch this now. Here it is, drive on the baseline. That makes that defense collapse, which then makes Ramey wide open.
Newman thought about it and says LaChance. He puts it on the floor. LaChance with the floater. LaChance can't get it to go. Goodman again. Goodman a third time. Wow.
Yeah, Goodman there again, just working hard, getting that second and third shots until he finally puts it in.
He is a load. Murray swings it again. Nice crisp pass. Ramey. Ramey can't get it to fall. Goodman with the board, and here come the Lancers, up by 18 points. Inside, Rasmussen, quick hands, Ramey steals it, Ramey kicks it ahead, Murray gathers. Murray can't finish, neither can Prochet, Dahlke does. Dahlke knocks it down.
That was a good effort on the part of the Falls. Murray couldn't put it in, Prochet puts it back up, gets a third shot here with Dahlke.
Dahlke with a nice finish.
Yeah.
Oh, boy, Goodman with the inside look again.
You know, I mean, he's just killing them on the inside. Nobody's giving any kind of pressure or defense. He kind of roams that inside there and dominates.
Nice pass. Richardson to Dahlke. Dahlke with eight on the night. He's having a nice ball game. Indians need to play some defense.
All right, now you notice here, Falls is in a different D now. Looks like it's almost a 2-3, like a matchup, but they're still not boxing out. You go to a 2-3 zone primarily so that you can box out and that you can dominate on the inside, and you can still pressure the ball, especially if you're doing a matchup 2-3.
Hey, they're not even touching Goodman. Goodman is just getting the ball clean, putting it up clean. He's got 20 points.
Yeah, see, and you got to get a body on him. And I don't care whether you're playing man or zone, you still have to get a body on him. It's like you always got to know where that guy is because he's the guy who's hurting.
Coach Leffel goes with a little more height. Coyer comes into the ball game. Dahlke will get abreast. Indians set to inbound. It'll be Coyer that will do that, looking into the teeth of that 1-3-1 zone that the Lancers like to throw out there. You made a great point about Mariachi. He's got long arms. Coyer, nice look, can't get it to fall. Goodman with the rebound, gives it up to LaChance. LaChance looks, LaChance, Rasmussen, jumper on the way. We'll let him shoot that all day. That doesn't fall. Here comes Ramey and the Indians.
Oh,
Murray,
hustle.
Nice
good
hustle.
Ah, you don't want to pass while you're jumping in the air there. LaChance.
Wow, LaChance, that was pretty.
Yeah, Ramey went for the steal. Pull up, take the J.
Nice move to get past Ramey.
Yeah.
Coyer.
See, and they're getting that rotation. They know that that weak side guy coming from the opposite corner is open if they penetrate. That's a good job. Nice pass by Ramey.
Coyer gets on the board. 22 points for the Indians. LaChance. LaChance heating up. Oh, my gosh. LaChance with a beautiful pass to Goodman, who had the position, and he finishes. This is just pretty.
Just nobody has got their hands up. Look, see, all
too
the
easy.
Defenders have their hands down. You can't have your hands down. You're playing defense, man-to-man or zone. You got to have your hands up.
Ramey in trouble, gives it up to Murray. Murray with the jumper. Murray knocks it down from the perimeter.
Now, to cut this at all, you're going to have to play some D.
Good hustle by Murray. Ball stays with the Lancers. 18 points. Murray raises his hand. He needs a breather. Murray says, get me out of here, and Coach Leffel does. Dahlke is back into the ballgame. Ramey also gets a breather. McLeod back into the ballgame. Prashay, Coyer, Dahlke, McLeod, and Richardson on the floor for the Indians. Jumper on the way, LaChance. That's just pretty.
Gets a high release, nice follow through. From a balance standpoint, it looks like he's even a little bit off balance, but he's got a great eye on the ball and
good body control.
Yeah, works. It works.
The Indians looking to figure out this 1-3-1. Prashay goes inside. Prashay with a very nice look. Prashay with the finish. Jason Prashay with 5 points.
Nice penetration, reverse layup there.
Boy, let's talk a little bit about Riley LaChance and Elijah Goodman. They're just really getting it done. They know their game. They know what they need to do. Goodman has 22 points. LaChance has 13. The rest of the team, 10.
Well, and isn't that going to be an interesting thing, the LaChance-Goodman connection there? If LaChance scored 32 the last time and they had 15, we're kind of almost in reverse, you know, position right now, and it's Goodman's turn to score 30.
Makes it tough
careful.
To defend, tough to come up with a game plan when you got the guy who's the bruiser and can get it done inside,
right.
And then you got LaChance, who's a finesse player, a floater, a jump shooter.
Yeah.
You throw in Rasmussen, who can bang inside at 6'8". Not an easy team to go up against. Brad Newman has some speed at their point guard.
Right. Yeah, I think it's a team, and this is, we got to remember, this is a relatively young team that they've got. They've got some guys coming back. Again, only one first-team all-Greater Metro starter in LaChance.
Great hands by Prashay. Prashay knocks the ball out of bounds. Pass intended for Mollinsack.
Yeah, think about that. What do you think the Lancers are going to be like next year?
yeah, right, exactly. All these kids are coming back.
Most of them back. With a chance to be a senior by that time.
Goodman, too.
Yeah.
Boy, Goodman's right in front of us. He is huge.
Yeah.
It's like looking at a professional linebacker.
Yeah, did you notice how in basketball they don't give you the weight? You know, football, they're all about the height and weight, you know, but not in basketball. They just... But he is definitely a strong young man.
LaChance with another jumper.
Nice. That's great. Dahlke gets that pass, takes it right to the hoop.
Dahlke with 10 on the night. Goodman once again inside. Goodman once again punishes the Indians. 20-point margin, 105 left.
Still, I still think we're not pressuring the passer enough. And then once the ball is inside, we don't have our hands up on D.
McLeod to Ramey. Ramey swings it. That's Coyer. Coyer puts it on the deck, looking for a little bit of help. Dahlke from downtown. That is off the mark. The Lancers gather. 42 seconds left. LeChance smiles as he brings it into the front court. Between the wicket, gives the ball up, looks to get it back, and he does. Guarded by Ramey. LeChance posting up Ramey inside. Lancers don't see it, and they reset. Nice job, McLeod, and then he is fouled. McLeod forces the turnover and draws the foul.
Yeah, see, if you're on the varsity level and you don't protect the ball, you're going to have that happen. Nice job by McLeod.
Adams up by 20 points, crying to the referee. Did not like that call.
Always got to keep working them.
Sounds like a coach talking. Let's see, they're going to get 22, it looks like, on the foul again. That is Wallen.
Yeah. And interestingly enough, look what you've got in there for Central. You don't have Goodman in there. You don't have Rasmussen in there.
You're right.
You got LeChance in there. So they're going light and small with a lot of fouls to give.
Here comes Ramey inside. He kicks the ball. McLeod, Ramey. Jumper on the way. Off the mark. Dahlke, does he get it off? He does, but it won't go.
He kind of got bumped a little bit, but 1/10 of a second. Can you score in 1/10 of a second? The answer is
no. These guys running the clock were in our gym. And that will bring a close to the third quarter. There you see the score. The Lancers on top of the Indians, 48-28, one period left to go. And we picked up in that third quarter where we left off at halftime with LeChance and Goodman doing a lot of damage. Elijah Goodman has 24 points. That's what I have him down for. Riley LeChance with 15 and came on a little bit in that quarter. Boy, it's hard to find an answer for those two guys.
Well, and to the point of the Falls, what are they doing? They did score 15 points.
They did.
In the quarter, okay. So offensively, it's better than a two-point quarter. But on the other hand, they gave up so many points.
They gave up 19.
19. So, you know, giving up, you know, making 15 but giving up 19 and you're already down by, you know, as much as you were at halftime, that's not a strategy. So, once again, from a coaching standpoint, what you have to do is you have to say we've got to play better defense. We've got to get our hands up on defense. We've got to contest the shots. We've got to make sure that there isn't anything there. And then the second thing we have to do is score on the offensive end. And, you know, maybe you got to try something else. Do you have, like, a full-court press maybe that you want to try? Or a half-court trap or something like that?
Pick out areas of the game to work on, to improve on, looking ahead to the next contest.
Yeah, because you're going to get this all on tape. You're going to watch it on Falls Cable Access, and you can kind of pick it apart, and you can kind of decide, you know, well, that was good or that wasn't so good, or next time we got to try this. But get it on tape. You know, let's see what that, you know, half-court trap looks like or the full-court press does.
I'll be interested to see how much of LeChance and Goodman we see going into this fourth quarter. LeChance is back out on the floor. Goodman is not, and the Lancers are set to inbound, and they do. LeChance has the ball and brings it into the front court. His team up by 20. Newman, a starter, is back on the floor. Rasmussen back on the floor. And LeChance from downtown, he's trying to catch up with Goodman. He doesn't like it that Goodman has more points than him.
I totally agree. And he's got just such nice picture-perfect form. Great follow-through. Snaps the wrist, follows through all the way. That's a nice, nice form.
Murray double team, gets it back to Ramey with some mustard on it, too. Ramey gathers, resets the offense, swings it. That's McLeod. McLeod to Ramey. This 1-3-1 is giving them headaches.
Now, see, now this is interesting, too. Now, you notice what else they did. They moved Rasmussen into that high post middle. Remember they had him on the wing before?
Right.
So now we'll see how he does on the inside.
Murray with the nice work.
Nice
Murray
tip.
Puts it back.
Nice tip. Good job.
Murray has four on the evening. Here you see Ramey creates the headache with the penetration. Jump shot goes up, and Murray will get the nice finish here.
Nice follow, yep.
Wow, Newman, who's 6 feet, trying to post Ramey up down there on the block. There's some battling going on. I think they're going to call Ramey for the foul. Both guys really going at it down there. Brad Newman, who's 6 feet. Ramey, who they list at 5'8".
And that's very positive.
Very generous?
Generous, positive. He plays bigger than that.
Yes, he does.
He plays bigger than that.
Richardson back into the ballgame. LeChance can't get that one to go. Nice defense by Richardson. over the back or out of bounds? Out of bounds, they say. Rasmussen, the big man, was standing out of bounds. Yeah. Indians to inbound.
Caught it with his foot on the baseline.
Here comes Ramey. Let's see if we can work on a little bit of offense here. They have the length, the Lancers do, in that 1-3-1 to really make things difficult. There's the extra pass. Ramey in the corner. Ramey on the wood. Ramey is fouled.
Yeah, see, and here's the challenge. When you penetrate, you got to get rid of it before four guys are on you. That's the challenge. And, you know, he's doing the right thing about the penetration, but if he penetrates and you got four guys on you, yeah, it's too late. See, that's too late. If he would have passed it one or two steps before that, he would have had wouldn't have gotten crushed. He's luckier.
LaChance has sat down. I wonder if we've seen the last of Riley LaChance for the night. We shall see. 6:20 left. His team up by 21. Rasmussen and Newman, the two starters that remain on the floor for the Lancers. Indians looking for some offense. The extra pass. It's Richardson to Ramey. Ramey lets it fly from downtown. Nothing but net. Nice look. Brandon Ramey knocks it down.
And he likes that 23-footer. I mean, that's,
he does.
You know, he doesn't want to step in closer. Look at that. Look at where he is. He's out there 22, 23 feet. Yep.
Oh, inside look denied. The foul call. Caleb Mortag went up for the dunk, and they're going to call Murray for the foul. That's all right. Don't give them that in our house.
Make them earn it from the free throw line. As long as it wasn't
foul.
A flagrant or anything like that, that's fine.
Caleb Mortag at the line.
It looks like Ramey is bleeding. He is. He's going to need to come out of the ball game.
And see, and he's got
a little bit of a bloody nose.
He's got it on his uniform as well, so hopefully they can either clean it off the uniform or get him another uniform change number.
That's what they're doing. They're going into the bin for the uniform there. The official you can see there in your background making sure there's no blood on the floor. 51-33. That is where we sit here. 5:53 left in the fourth quarter. This has been a tough afternoon, a tough evening, I should say, for the Indians. But the Lancers are a tough ball club. They're going to be battling near the top of this Metro Conference all year. Prechet checks back in while they try to get Ramey a new uniform and to get the bleeding to stop in his nose.
You know what's kind of interesting, too, about the bloodborne pathogen thing? I completely understand it, but have you ever seen him have to change a jersey in a football game?
Yeah, you're right. They don't do it.
They do not do it. There's blood all over the place in a football game, and they're not able to do that.
Oh, my God.
You can't
can you imagine?
Between the mud and the blood and everything else, you just can't see it.
Mortag knocks down the free throw. And the second as well. He has 4 points. All right, Ramey has the old Kleenex stuffed in the nose, and now he's wearing number 44. He'll look to check back in. Next dead ball. Indians on offense, still looking into that zone. McLeod is fouled. Newman committed the foul. Never thinks he ever commits a foul, but once again he did. All right, here comes Ramey back into the ball game. Now wearing number 44 for the Menomonee Falls Indians. McLeod will sit back down. Ramey sets the offense to Richardson. Zach Murray looks inside, gives it to Ramey. Ramey on the dribble. Ramey inside. Oh, nice pass. Dahlke can't handle it. Here come the Lancers. Good idea. A little bit of kickball. The Indians will get possession. Turnover. Gunnar Mollinsek kicks the ball out of bounds. 5:16 left, 20-point lead. All right, you're at this point. You're down by 20, Coach. I'm sure you were never in a situation where you were down by 20, but what do you do in this situation? What are you working on? What are you thinking? What are you telling your guys?
You know, I mean, I understand that there's going to be some people out there who's going to say, well, it's time for the coach to clear the bench and blah, you know, everything else. The bottom line is you don't want to throw in a towel in the first game of the Greater Metro Conference at this point. What you want to do is continue to say, ignore the score, and let's play some good basketball. Let's play some good defense. Let's get it on tape. Again, if we've got more than straight up man-to-man, let's get it on tape. Let's see what it looks like.
Let's work on some things.
And let's have some minor victories. You know, let's defend that inbounds play so they don't get any more easy layups. Let's make sure that they're not going to score, you know, easy fast break layups. Let's take something and say, okay, in the last 5 minutes, we did this. And I still think when you look at a time slot like this, 5 minutes in the fourth quarter, you say, our goal is to cut this lead in half. I know that's not going to get you the W, But if you can get it to a 10-point instead of a 20-point,
something to
build
on.
That's a moral victory. And then, again, you're now if you could be within 10 points of the team that almost beat the number one team in the state, see, you can...
That's saying something.
You
can build on that. You can work with that.
Yeah, it's the mental part of the game. You can really build on that. Hey, here's Jerry. One of the
happiest guys we know. He sure looks happy, doesn't he?
Does he look happy? He doesn't realize that we got the camera on him.
Look at how good he looks. He looks good in that gray shirt.
Well, and this was just payback because, of course, he announced before the game that our director, Harry Stetzel, was 81 years old today.
And, wow, 81?
Yeah, he looks really good for 81.
He does look good for 81. I was thinking 71. He looks good for 81.
I was trying to be nice and said, 51.
And LaChance and Goodman are both back into the ballgame for the Lancers and says Newman on the spin move. Newman turns the ball over. Here come the Indians. Ramey has two, gives it up. The block and one counted. Prochet knocks it down, and he'll go to the free throw line.
Nice job. Good penetration. And there's another. That's a victory. Three man attacking one, gets in there, and said he didn't set his feet in time. So he gets not only the basket, but he also gets the chance for the three-point play.
Can't get it to fall. The Lancers are working on the same thing. They have their starters back in, also trying to work on a little bit of their game.
Yep. And, I'm guessing, it's just to make sure that they don't also offensively or defensively throw in the towel from that standpoint. They don't really want this to be a close game. They don't want the Falls to make any moral victories here.
I think LaChance wants some more points. There he is on the ball. Sweet floating jumper off the mark. Battle for the board. Ramey comes out of there with it. Looks up. Nice pass to Dahlke. Dahlke to the rim, and he finishes.
Dahlke's got some nice moves to the basket. Is that
12
now?
He's got 12 points.
Yeah. Penetrates. A little soft. Underhanded hook.
There's Goodman. Stay out there, Goodman. Stay out there. Coach Leffel not happy. They're not being aggressive. Dahlke, he's going to get called for the block.
Ball's on number two, Dan Dahlke.
And correct me if I'm wrong, I don't think either team got into the bonus
half.
And right now we're at 4-6, so we don't have even a chance for a bonus yet in the second half.
I'll call that one a shooting foul, so Newman will go to the line.
And, some of that can be attributed to the fact that one team's playing a zone. And, you don't tend to foul as much in a zone. But the Falls just really hasn't been, doing a lot of fouling either.
Newman knocks them both down. 55-37. They get the ball into the front court. It's Richardson, knocked away, stolen. Here comes Mortag. Mortag to LaChance. LaChance to the big man, gives it up. Back to Mortag. Little too fancy. LaChance ends up with it. And with the shooter's touch, knocks it down. That gives LaChance 20.
Mike gets the first in front of the rim, left side, rolls back, hits it, hits the goal, and goes in.
And you're a shooter, I guess that's what happens.
Yeah, you said shooter's touch, exactly.
Inside look, Prochet. Prochet can't get it to go. Here come the Lancers. 3:24 left. They're going to get Richardson with the foul.
Yeah, see, in the old days, what we used to teach was you catch that ball coming across the lane like that, you always put a head and shoulder fake in there. If you can put that head and shoulder fake in there, you're going to have a chance to score, but then you're also going to get the chance for the three-point play. So,
Lancer lead is 20, and they will inbound the ball, or Mortag set to inbound. 3:23 left in the ball game. Right in front of the scorer's table, Newman gets the ball in the backcourt, guarded by Ramey. Ramey almost with the turnover. Newman back on the ball. There's big boy Goodman out top. LaChance. Oh, LaChance with the nice pass. Goodman misses it. Goodman, oh my gosh. Goodman with three looks and he knocks it down.
I tell you, you give a guy like Goodman three opportunities to put a ball in a basket. Nine times out of ten, he's going to do it. So
Goodman has 26 points on the night, scored 15 in the opener. Riley LaChance has 20. When you got a guy who can score 26 and another guy who can score 20, that's a whole lot of offense.
Yeah.
Makes you a really good coach when you have guys who can score that many points, doesn't it?
Well, and And to the coach's credit, what he's doing is he's putting those guys in a position to be able to do those things. Some of it is the natural talent that an athlete has, but a good coach makes sure that the offense is running the proper way, that they're putting in positions and into positions on the offensive series, where to do it, how to do it. And then also, even when you do the inbounds plays, you kind of design it so that, okay, who does a nice, you know, solid back pick, and then who can come off of a pick well. So you're kind of designing it for, you know, success, and that's the thing. If you know your players and you can set them up for that type of success, that's great. Corey Gala, the new principal. The new principal here at Menomonee Falls.
Bob Vitale is sitting next to him.
Bob's been there for quite a while. Used to be a Fayed teacher here. And
football coach.
Head football coach, and now assistant principal here.
He's the enforcer.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Let's see if the Indians can finish strong here. Maybe run some good offense.
One of the best hires I ever had for an assistant principal. Great job.
Knocked out of bounds by the Lancers. LeChance remains on the floor. Goodman is sitting out. See if LeChance tries to catch him in the box score. LeChance with 20. Goodman with 26. The Indians looking to run some nice offense here. Still facing that 1-3-1 zone. There's the pass. Prochet with the travel. Russo fed it to Prochet. Prochet traveled. That means the Lancers are set to inbound. 2:51 left here in the ball game. A lot of the air has gone out of the gym. Yeah, Coach Leffel still working hard. Wants his guys to work hard as well. You can see him there down in the front of our screen.
It's tough. They've got a few advantages, Central.
That's not going to count before the shot. It's tough also because this program has gotten used to winning. Last year, a little bit of a down year, and they were 14-10. Still a nice year, but the school has gotten used to winning, so they're not accustomed to this. They'll start 0-3. LeChance comes out. He finishes the game with 20 points.
Yeah, and Central finished, we mentioned this before, Central finished second, and then overall 17-6. That's a nice year. Not a 20-win season, but hey, it's a good year. Yeah, those big, fat, juicy passes are going to get taken at some point.
Ramey can't get it to fall. Here come the Lancers. They look to push the ball. Ramey is back. Newman, shake and bake, knocks it down. Newman with 7 points.
Good body control on this. Pulls up, takes the J, nice follow through, puts it in. That's kind of what you're supposed to do in those situations.
Here come the subs for the Lancers. They empty the bench. So do the Indians. Shields is back into the ballgame. Shore is back into the ballgame. Coyer comes in for the Indians. Devin Jackson is back on the floor. And Dahlke will come out as well. Russo remains in the ballgame.
It's pretty nice. Now, 14 just came into game for Brookfield Central. And he's, you know, obviously kind of like second, third string, right? 6'7".
Big kid.
They're not losing a lot of height on this one.
Under 2 minutes left. 2 minutes left in this Greater Metro matchup. Here come the Indians. They run some offense. Coyer with the long jumper. Pretty stroke, and he knocks it down.
Had a great view of that one. Pulls up, squares up. You're going to swing it.
Coyer with 4 points on the night.
Yeah. There it is, Coyer.
Nice look, nothing but net.
That's the way it's supposed to go in. Good job, Coyer. Oh, that was a chance to seal that one.
Sure was. Russo almost had it. Malsonek is on the ball now. 1:25 left. What is the call? 3 second call.
Substitution for the Lancers. Number 20, Drew Peterson.
Peterson into the ball game for the Lancers. Malinsek is out. Russo set the inbound for the Indians. Gets it into Devin Jackson. Indians down by 23 here in the fourth quarter. Jackson on the ball. Coyer sets the pick. Shields lets it fly. Can't get it to fall. Nice. Russo goes up. Can't get it to fall either. Good effort by Anthony Russo. Lancers break the pressure. 1 minute left in this ball game. There's the foul. Knetter went up for the jumper and was fouled.
Well, and what's nice, too, now is Falls picking up full court, giving us a little bit of full court pressure. You got some fresh guys in there. Mix it up a little bit. Might have been interesting to see what would have happened if you would have done that maybe just a little bit earlier.
Knetter will get a second here. Six-foot junior. Battle for the board. Jump ball? No, foul. Foul called on Russo.
Yeah, 23. His first,
teammate. Russo's first foul.
And I think they just did this for effect now so that both teams got into the bonus. Just because I had mentioned that we weren't in the bonus at all. So.
Tischler misses the front end of the 1-1. The Indians come out of there with the basketball.
You know, and to that point about free throws, I just really, you know, think it's an important part of the game that we've kind of lost perspective on. I think you get an opportunity, especially when your team isn't particularly playing well, free throws should be an automatic. And I don't care whether you're the biggest kid on the team or the smallest kid on the team, everybody can shoot a free throw.
Well, look, you have Dwight Howard on the Lakers who's shooting like 48%, and his team has lost a couple ball games because they continue to foul him down the stretch instead of letting Kobe shoot the ball.
Yep.
You got a guy who's in the NBA and can't hit his free throws. Shields knocks
Shields
down the long one.
Hit.
Here's
a
look at it.
Pull up, square, right there.
Boom.
Nice.
Ten seconds left in this Greater Metro matchup.
Oh, that's good.
Over and back, turnover. Nice defense, pressure applied by Shields. Indians will get one final crack at it here.
It would be nice if they could pull in one more basket or a free throw.
Shields on the ball. Not much time left. Somebody's going to have to put it up. Shields doesn't even get the shot off.
And this game is history.
And that is your final. The Brookfield Central Lancers 65. The Menomonee Falls Indians 43. Teams will come to center court. Nice show of sportsmanship. They'll shake hands. The first Greater Metro matchup for the Indians of the year is in the books. Let's run down some of the statistics for you. Elijah Goodman led the way for the Lancers with 26 points. Riley LaChance ended up with 20. Newman, their point guard, closed with 7 points. Mortag with 4. Mariachi with 1. Wallen with 2. Let's take a look at the Indians. Dahlke with a nice game, a good effort. He ended the game with 12 points. Brandon Ramey with 8. Prechet had 7. Murray and Coyer both had 4. Russo and Shields both had 3.
What Dahlke leading scorer.
Dahlke leading scorer. And Dahlke had 4 points the first game. So LaChance and Goodman, we're going to talk about the Indians in a second, but if you look at these two guys, pretty impressive. If you consider what they did the first game, LaChance is now averaging 26 a game. Goodman averaging just over 20 a game.
Yeah.
That's a pretty nice duo to have.
Well, and if you look at the style of play for those guys, they're not selfish.
Mm-hmm.
They're team players. You know, I still think the majority of the score that Goodman gets is kind of work hard. You know, they get it to him, and so he touches it.
But good position, works hard.
And then he'll get, you know, he's had how many putbacks and how many offensive rebounds and stuff like that. So he deserves whatever he gets. And LaChance can score kind of from everywhere. I mean, he's not really an inside player, but, I mean, he could score on a fast break. He can pull up and take the J. He can take the shot from the baseline or the top of the key. So,
and I think you brought it up a couple of times. This team is also a reflection of Mark Adams.
Yes.
And the work that he puts in and the type of program that he runs.
Yeah, victory number 199. Yeah, and really enjoying it. Like we mentioned before, he's actually retired from teaching, and he says he's having more fun now because he has even more time to prepare for the basketball. And
if you're Coach Leffel, are there positives you can take away from this ball game?
Well, I think there were moments. I wish they would have strung together better moments, you know, for longer periods of time. But there were individual things. You know, it's some nice shooting when they did square up and when they did have the open shot. You know, some picture-perfect kinds of things. They started out well. I mean, anytime you can get your team to understand the importance of coming out of the locker room and getting some intensity in that
mm-hmm.
first, you know, 4 to 5 minutes of any game, that gets you off on the right foot, you know. And in that case, you did get a little bit of a lead, you know, there at that particular point. And certainly the first quarter was probably their bright spot, you know, 11-9 at the end of the first quarter.
So who do the Indians have next?
Well, that's a great question.
You're the most prepared guy
I know.
If I give you a second here, I know that you have it.
You do? Yes, I'm sure.
We're going to bring you a lot of these games, by the way, on Falls Cable Access coming up this year. Also, a lot of the girls' games, and the girls have a very exciting team. So who's up next for the Indians?
It's Tosa East, and it's at the Falls. So
at the Falls, 7:30 on December 11th.
And home games are, you know, that's kind of nice. If you can get a couple of home games early and you get the fans in, you know, involved and everything else and stuff, so that could be good. And then right after that, the 14th, you got Marquette University.
That's
always a barn burner. Anytime you can play the Falls versus Marquette, that's a big one. And last year, because actually Marquette finished below the Falls in the standings, you know Marquette's looking at this game and want to say, well, that's the game we want to take. We want to make sure we win that one. So you know the next two games. Tulsa East has a great reputation. You know,
great
always,
program, great history.
Great program. Always have kids that are really great players and stuff, and their coaching staff is well prepared too. So this is not an easy role. I mean, I think if
probably
it's
a tough conference.
Coach
there
Luff
aren't easy games.
At this, right, and his non-conference wasn't easy, so
good for the program.
Good for the program.
All right, there is your final score. We want to thank our crew. There is Gordon Kirchhoff,
Don
Porisco, Ruben Glazier, Joe Crowley. There's some of the guys hiding behind the graphics. Harry Stetzel is our director. There's Ruben. Come on, stand up. Make yourself known.
Oh, he is standing up.
The hardest working crew, the greatest crew, these beautiful pictures, this incredible sound brought to you by those very hard working guys, their leader, Harry Stetzel. I'm John Merkier, Coach Bill Hintz. It's been a lot of fun. Your final score, 65-43. Thank you for watching Greater Metro Basketball on Falls Cable Access.
Happy birthday.